Hello everyone, welcome back to WayKen Rapid Manufacturers channel. My name is TJ. Programming is a relatively arcane process, even within CNC machining shop. How well a programmer understands the design intent of the product directly affects the choice of toolpath design and tool selection, which in turn affects the final machining result. Let's use this part as an example to show you how our programmer gets a basic idea of the product design intent by comparing the part features in 3D joints with the tolerance requirements in 2D joints and then creates a machining plan. First, we learned from the designer that this part is one of the shared components of the gears. It will work with the other two components to support the bearing and ensure its normal operation inside the shell. With this basic information, we carefully examine the structure of this part in the 3D joints. It is not difficult to realize that the hole on the left will have the shaft part passing through it, and the circular bottom on the right will form a support for another shaft part. In order to achieve the core functions of this part, the designer must set strict requirements for the positional tolerance of these two areas. Three strict positional tolerance requirements have been marked in the corresponding areas. Of course, in addition to these few holes for connecting the bearings, if we look at the 3D files again, we can see that there are 8 small holes around the edge of this part. Based on our experience, these holes are either used for positioning or fixing. Therefore, they are either throw holes or tapped holes. Again, in the 2D file, positional tolerance requirements has been marked in the corresponding area. Once we have a rough understanding of the designer's intention, we have a basic framework for our programming approach. In this very case, how to ensure the positional accuracy of these important structures and areas is at the core of the entire toolpath design. Ensure that all the structural features with relevant positional requirements are machined in the same setup. Therefore, our final operation is completed in 3 steps. The first step is to machine all the features on this side to ensure the positional accuracy. The second step is to machine the features on the side. The third step is to machine the features on the bottom. Fill the part with plaster during the third step to control the deformation of the part. That's all for today. Thank you again for joining us for this video, and we hope you have learned something today. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to our channel and give us a like. See you next time. Bye-bye.